the Torrey Snow Podcast.
WBAL.com/podcast.
The strangest thing popped up on my Twitter yesterday. Saw a tweet from Adele. That's actually a tweet from Robert Lang, actually, putting on the radar that there was a delegate expressing dismay that someone had asked, that had offered prayer for Russian leadership on the floor of the Maryland House of Delegates. And they were quite dismayed. And so I went and did a little bit of investigating. And it turns out it's true, right? Delegate Bob Long out of Baltimore County. He's in District 6. Delegate Bob Long had the following invocation to offer at a recent House of Delegates hearing.
The prayer this morning will be offered by the good gentleman from Baltimore County.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. We all could bow our heads. Dear Heavenly Father, we just come before you today, Lord, and we just ask for your guidance and your wisdom to do the people's business down here. We also need to pray for our leaders in Washington, D.C., and in Russia, and all over this world. We live in some troubled times, and we need your guidance and wisdom at this time. We need peace. We all need peace. Amen.
Quorum call.
So that was that's the context. I love me a good context. And of course, there were a number of people who pushed back against this. They're offended at the idea that somebody would offer prayer for Russian leadership. And that would include Vladimir Putin. And I mean, I thought this was an interesting perspective. And I thought about a few scriptures. And I'm like, I could kind of see where he's coming from. But I had to ask my pastor. I texted him a text. I'm like, hey, pastor, what do you think about this? And we got into a very interesting discussion. I'm like, oh, well, I think our audience might be interested in hearing this. I know not everybody that listens is religious or a person of faith, but it is something that's come up quite a bit, right? We do know that faith is intrinsically tied to the Ukrainian people. I know that in my situation, I know people that are serving over in Ukraine as missionaries, and there's a big religious overtone to a lot of things that are going on here. Governor Hogan recently attended some services, and I believe that there's going to be a statewide moment of prayer this evening for Ukraine. So this is something that has been a part of the discussion. What happens when an elected official stands before a gathering of policymakers and asks for prayer for Russia? That was the question that I have for Pastor Joel Porcher of Anchor Baptist Church. Pastor Porcher agreed to join me to discuss this. Pastor Joel, thanks so much for joining our program. And you heard what the delegate said, and we kind of talked about this a bit. What are your initial reactions when you hear a prayer like that from someone on the House of Delegates floor?
Yeah, Torrey, it's good to be with you, and thank you for the opportunity. The first thing that comes to mind is, anytime we speak publicly on an issue and anytime we lead publicly in prayer, we need to think about what we're saying. We need to think about being very precise in our language. And we need to recognize that what we say is going to be scrutinized, and frankly, it should be scrutinized. So that's probably one of the first things I think about. Another thing that came to mind is the rush to judgment on his words. When someone gets, when somebody hears a situation like this, I think sometimes we act as if people are not, are always going to be precise when they speak, that they've already thought things through clearly. Right. And it was pretty obvious to me when he was praying that he had not thought through things carefully. He was a bit nervous. And so the way that it came out is probably not exactly the way that he intended it. And I think we should also be cautious that we don't rush to the absolute worst conclusion,
right,
about what someone may have meant when they said that. And, you know, with the social media world the way that it is, I think people are constantly looking for gotcha moments. And that was one of those moments. So, you know, I kind of think of it with a balance. You've got to be precise. You're leading people in prayer. You're speaking publicly on this issue. But also, we know that sometimes people do not use precise language, and they get nervous, and things come out in the way that they didn't intend it. And we should get clarification when somebody, you know, uses terms like give them wisdom, what kind of wisdom are we talking about? You understand what I mean?
Yeah. So, it's interesting you mentioned that, because he does yeah. offer a bit of clarification on this. As a matter of fact, I'll go ahead and let everyone hear what he had to say.
Madam Speaker.
Mm-hmm. Gentlemen, Baltimore County.
Could I have a point of privilege, please?
Gentlemen, go ahead.
Thank you. I just want to make it perfectly clear. When I was praying for wisdom for the leaders of Russia. I also want to pray for peace around Ukraine, put a protective hedge before I was stopped. And I want to make sure that I didn't offend anyone here. And I just want to make that perfectly clear. Believe me, I know what's happening in this world. We do need to pray for this world. Thank you.
So Pastor Joel, it is an interesting topic that came to my mind, because people are rightly mm-hmm. pointing out there are scriptures, in the Bible, that talk about praying for kings. And in the context, mm-hmm. right, you were dealing with people that were far worse than Putin. I mean, you think about the Roman Empire and some of the people mm-hmm. that they were being asked to pray for. And even in the context of Christ's message of, loving your enemies and praying for those that despitefully use you. What should mm-hmm. people be thinking about when, thinking about someone like Putin, who clearly is in the wrong, clearly engaged in evil activities? What is the right and perhaps Christian approach to look at something like this?
Yeah, so when we talk about praying for people in authority, the passage that comes to mind that you're alluding to is 1 Timothy 2, and it says that we're to pray for people in authority, but then it explains what we're ultimately praying for, that we'll be able to lead a quiet and peaceable life in all godliness, and then ultimately it's so that people can practice their faith and they can share the gospel freely. So when you're praying for people in authority, it would be very clear in that context that you're not praying that a person who is a tyrant and is abusing people, murdering people, doing vicious, evil things, that person would prosper. But you may actually be praying that person will be stopped and brought to immediate justice, so that order can be restored and society can be peaceable again. When we talk about the most loving thing that a person could do when someone is in a scenario like a Putin, who is very evil in his actions, what he's doing is so destructive and so disruptive, the most loving thing that could happen to him is that he stops so he can't continue. And the most loving thing for your neighbor is that they are defended from his tyranny. So when we're praying for people in a situation like that, we're ultimately pleading with God to intervene so that peace can be restored and people can actually live peaceable lives. And he knows the best way to resolve that. And many times when we're praying in a scenario like that, we don't actually know the best way to go about that happening, because we don't know all the potential outcomes with a certain course of action.
Right. We're speaking with Pastor Joel Porcher of Anchor Baptist Church. And yeah, it is becoming fashionable for politicians to have moments of prayer. You have the governor, he's going and, visiting churches, and I think he's going to be leading in a moment of prayer. There does seem to be a desire from a lot of people to, look at the situation. I think people do feel kind of helpless. Mm-hmm. What is your counsel or advice, or what would you say to people that are looking to invoke a prayer or to pray for this situation? What should people pray for as it relates to both the people of Ukraine and perhaps Russia and the soldiers in Russia and the citizens of Russia and the leadership of Russia? What does that look like?
Yeah, so it's interesting you asked that. Tonight we're going to have a special prayer meeting at our church, and I'm actually going to specifically address a lot of these issues. And I would kind of break it down into a couple of categories. One is, I think just expressing how we feel about what we see. A lot of scripture, particularly in the Psalms, is people lamenting the pain and the sorrow and the frustration, the confusion of the kinds of things that we see when evil prevails for periods in history. And I think that's a completely appropriate thing for us to express. And we see these pictures in the news. We come exposed to these stories. I think, confessing our own inadequacy and our lack of wisdom and knowing the best way to resolve it. These are very complicated matters, and expressing our complete dependence on God to intervene in these scenarios. So I think that's one side. I think another side is that we should ask God to intervene in ways that we can clearly see that scripturally says are just and right. So, you know, to pray that a tyrant who is abusing people is stopped, and that is a completely biblical prayer, that people that are truly suffering will be sustained during this very difficult season, that that people's lives will be preserved. There are lots and lots of things that people that are that have the means to actually assist, that they'll be able to connect with the right channels to do that. You know, in a time like this, there are lots of people that they want to help, and frankly, their help gets exploited because they get into a channel that is being misused, so that mm-hmm. people will be directed to channels that are actually managing those resources correctly. You know, there are lots of people on the ground in Eastern Europe that are trying to assist people in getting to safe places. And I really believe that we should, you know, pray that God's hand protects and prospers in those situations. And the truth is that the decisions that leaders are making, they're very delicate. And, you know, we should be thankful we're not the ones making those decisions. These people need wisdom, and they need God to grant them a special measure of wisdom in these situations. So those are some of the things that we'll pray. And I'm, you know, I'm going to go to a lot of specifics tonight as our church gets together. And I encourage, you know, other ministers who maybe come in contact with this program, I'd encourage you to do the same. But being very specific, if there's a scriptural statement about a matter, then we know this is something that God would want to happen. And so we should pray in light of that.